This is gonna cost me so much later on. I know it. I'm gonna say sorry for what I'm about to do to Blue right now.
What?
You know, the thing with temporary points, Tim, is they're just that, temporary.
For some reason, I feel like it's a bluff.
Watch me lose this fight. I'm not gonna rage quit. I'm gonna flip the table if I lose this fight. Hello, everyone, and welcome back
to the
Wolf Pack.
No, not bad. It's pretty clean. It was a little bit subpar to Reams, but it's okay. They both know Reams. And also, we got a new person to the channel today, too.
Hey.
Back to back. Welcome, Nasir, to the channel. You saw Josh last time from Warline.
Yep.
And today, we are doing a three-player run-through of Kemet, Blood and Sand. Also, make sure you turn on your subtitles because this rule has a lot of nuances, a lot of questions, a lot of updates to the rulebook. So if there are any updates to the game that we're playing, they're going to be updated right onto the subtitles. So every time Josh messes up, please let us know in the comments down below. All right. So right now I'm playing as Anubis.
I'm playing as a Sobek.
Mm-hmm. I'm playing as, I don't know how to pronounce this.
Ujet.
Yeah. I mean, all the factions have a nice little name.
They also, There is no asymmetry involved. It's specifically color. But I'm starting over here in the bottom right corner. We got Josh in the middle, and then Nasir to the left. So we'll explain our actions briefly as we go, and then after that, we're just gonna cut to the chase and make sure we down the green faction as fast as we can. All right, shall we begin? When you start the game, you actually buy the very first level of a power tile, and you start in reverse turn order. So we'll go with blue first, and then green, and then back to me.
So I'm gonna pick the priest tile, which is right here, which just gives me an extra prayer point every single time I pray.
You know what? I am going to get the priest tile as well.
Looks like I will take the most powerful tile in the entire game. Level one, please, of recruiting scribe. First action of my turn, so we're going to take these mini action selection markers and then place them on any of these slots in our pyramid. So I'm gonna take the first one and put it here, which is gonna allow me to gain two prayer points. So we start off with seven, and I'm gonna end up at 9. This is our currency for the entire game.
It's my turn. What I'm gonna do is actually build my pyramid. So instead of placing it on the prey like Tim did, I'm placing it on the pyramid. What that allows me to do is just pay a cost to build up one of the pyramids I have on my board. Currently I have my pyramid built up to level 3. I'm going to pay the cost to build it up to level 4. So,
he just maxed out his pyramid on the first turn. Okay.
It's going for that glass cannon. Right.
So I pay the cost, which is 4. Is that correct?
Yep.
All right. So I go down from 7 to 3. But because I maxed out my pyramid, I also am awarded a gold coin.
Yep. 9 points and game is over. So that's one temporary point that can be taken away.
That's the permanent point.
Mm-hmm.
Oh,
yeah. Right, and I am similarly gonna build my pyramid. I'm gonna build my blue tier pyramid by 2 tiers. So that's gonna be a total cost of 5 prayer points. So we'll drop that down to 2. 2 points for level 2, and then an extra 3 points for level 3. And I will add these here. And that will be my turn.
Also, when you start off, you get 3 levels of your pyramid to diversify. For me and Josh, we both chose to do a level 1 foundation, but then Nasir decided to do the glass cannon and have 3 layers of a pyramid to start out with. So with that second action, I'm going to follow suit, and I'm going to raise a pyramid 2. And let's raise blue to 3 as well. So that's going to cost me 3 plus 2, 5 points. So 9 minus 5, I'm at 4, and I'm going to add 2 more levels to my pyramid.
Yeah, so what I'm going to do is I will buy this turn. First one I'm going to buy is the level 1 that decreases the cost of all the other tiles by 1. And then because I have this gold, what I can do is use that as well to buy a second tile this turn. I will be using that. Now, because I have the priestess token, the cost that is dictated on the top left of these is now going to be reduced by 1. So I only have to pay, I forgot to pay the 1 for the priestess. I only have to pay 2 for any of these 3 cost tiles. So I will be getting this one.
Okay.
And my turn, yeah.
Okay, and I'm
gonna end my turn. I've heard that since freaking Yu-Gi-Oh! End my turn.
I'm gonna do the same. I'm gonna put my token here on the white token, which just lets me pay get one level one white card. And I'm gonna do the same and get the priestess token, and that's gonna end my turn.
Okay, make this quick too. And I'm gonna buy. So I'm gonna put this on white, and I'm gonna buy a level one diamond. Let's go ahead and do a priestess. Two, please.
Ooh, they're actually out.
Yeah.
He snatched them all
quicker than that. Set up in the first two turns. Okay, what about the other one?
Nope.
No, both of them.
Oh, hell no. I didn't realize this. Okay, fine. I shall buy another one.
Which one would you like?
I'll buy red. Okay, red, and I'm going to get Priest of Mathet, which is going to give me plus one movement every time I move my troops. These guys, man, hoarding all my diamond tiles.
Yeah, my turn. So I'm out of my, what are these called again? The money?
Prayer points.
Prayer points?
Oh yeah, I'm out of prayer points. So I'm going to pray to bring that up a little bit. I go up to three because I have the plus one from the priest.
Oh, you mean the one I want to buy, right?
What was that?
You mean the one I wanted to buy, right?
Yeah. I mean, you know, first come, first serve. Mm.
I am actually going to buy a red card, and can I get the one that is plus one to attack? So this charge token adds one to attack every single time I'm the attacker, and I will explain more as we go to battle.
Back to me. Two actions left before the day phase is over, and I'm gonna go to movement. So by the end of your turn, you also have to make sure that all of your action selection tokens have at least one on each tier of the pyramid, the first three. The top of the pyramid is actually going to be a bonus action that you'll see in play later on when I wipe out Nasir's defenses over
there. I like how I'm the target here. It's almost like I've won before.
So you won the last one, and it was such a close game because Josh had that one at 9 and he like came out of nowhere, took him in for 11 points.
Took it right under me.
Okay, so you can also teleport on your turn too by spending 2 points going from the district of your city to any obelisk. And I think I'm gonna do just that. I'm gonna spend 2 points, one and two, and take all my five and teleport to the island. Ooh. And can I have that temporary point, please? Looks like we're tied for now, sir.
Yes, we are.
Okay.
My turn. What I'm going to do is, you know what? I'll recruit one of my units. So I'll bring them up here. And then what's the cost for that again? Is it just one?
One.
Cool.
Mm-hmm. Nice.
Okay, and I am going to pray. And that gives me total for three because I have a bonus to one from my priest.
Nice. Final action for this turn. And for my final action, I would like to move as well and split these three, two over here. Okay. There goes the island for me.
Back to you. Turn. I'm going to pray. I'll get two more prayer points. Three. So I'm going back up to five.
Mm-hmm. Josh? Because I don't have a token on the third level, I have to do one of these two actions. And I'm going to choose to do the movement action, which will teleport. I'm going to do two of my troop here, and that gives me this temporary token. And that's the end of my turn.
Wow, this is the most passive I've ever seen you guys play. Very interesting. All right, now we are starting the night phase, and there's a whole slew of things that go on. First up is the offering. So whoever controls the Sanctuary of the Gods may remove two units from that troop in order to gain one divine FP.
Did you like
are you guys there? Oh, it's just me. Oh, sorry. Wait, this phase is just for me. Sorry. The offering. Can you please sacrifice two of my units?
There we go.
And one divine permanent point, please.
Where? Oh, thank you.
So these squares also are permanent points. These cannot be taken away from you, but these circles can. Those are temporary points. So that's one permanent point. Next is the Delta Temple Control. The player that controls that may remove one unit in order to gain five prayer points. Oh, wait, it's back to me again. Oh, sorry. I don't know why I'm reading for myself. Okay, so one death and five prayer points. One, two, three, four. This is going to cost me so much later on. I know it. Okay, now, next up is temple control.
Oh, I get three prayer points.
Yep.
Six and temple control.
Mm-hmm. So each player that controls two temples also would gain one divine fame point, but no one has two temples just yet.
Yeah, you do.
Yeah, you do. Right.
I think the first one's a sanctuary. Wait, so that one over there is a sanctuary and this is a temple. So I don't think that would count for the permanent point. And also don't want to be too much in the lead either way.
Are you sure?
We can handle it. The storm is coming.
I just want to make sure that, you know, things are calm for this game still. Next up is adoration. Everyone gains prayer points on the temples, which we all did already.
Right? Temples, yes.
Yep, we did already. And next one is divine intervention. Everyone's going to draw one divine intervention card. So these divine intervention cards are temporary cards that we can use during specific phases. And now we're all going to draw one each. Mm-hmm. You, and everyone is here.
And then lastly, I draw one.
Yep. And the awakening, everyone's going to take back their action tokens. And we're also going to gain two prayer points. And that is the end.
I also have one of these cards that allows me to build during the awakening phase. So I get to set a level for my pyramid. I will do red.
And then player order. So we start with blue.
I will go first.
And then Nasir chooses.
I'll go second.
Second. Yeah, I'll just move it using them here. And then lastly, Tim will go last.
And then the most powerful player right now in the lead with 3 points will go last. This sounds exactly like last game where I was talking so much freaking Smash. Okay.
So I'm first. Let's just go ahead and do this. I will, wrong token. I'm going to go ahead and buy a blue token. Give me the sandworm, please. Now the sandworm cannot be placed in any of the districts, but when recruited can be placed in any of the free spaces along with two troops that are tied to this unit.
During my turn, I'm also going to buy. Because I have the priestess, the cost is going to be one less. I'm going to buy the Priest of Amon. This card over here, during the night phase, when we gain two prayer points, what it allows me to do is gain plus 7.
That's such a good card.
It's pretty nice, yeah. Just make sure I have a lot of money. Oh, I forgot to pay the cost, so I go from 7 down to 4. You know what? I'm going to do one more thing just because I have the gold token. I'm going to pay another 3 and get this card. This is called Act of God. What it gives me is one silver action token. So on your turn, instead of just doing one action, you have an additional action on top.
Nice.
I think that's it for me.
Okay. I'm going to raise pyramid for this one and spend, 5 points. So I'm going from 8 to 3 in order to raise this one. 2 more levels. Done.
I'm also going to build my white pyramid just by 1 level though.
Okay.
So I'll pay 2 points, 1, 2, and I will get 1 level.
I'm just going to get a couple more resources. Okay. So I'm going to bring this up from 1 to 4.
I was going to say sorry for what I'm about to do to blue right now.
What? Why?
I shall spend a movement point. Ooh. And I'm going to teleport 1, 2, 3, 4 of these units from here to here. And then battle initiated in that region. So how battle works is we are both, everyone has the same exact hand of cards. So we have 8 cards total. With those 8 cards that are held in secret, we're going to play one and discard the other. I know exactly where you're going to play.
Do you?
I know exactly where you're going to play, so I'm going to do that. And then we're also going to discard the other one in secret. And we can also add in our secret divine intervention cards that have a combat symbol as well. Right now, Josh is completely overpowered and he's going to be destroyed. So no matter what he plays, it's game over.
Okay.
Ready?
Yes. So I will be discarding this card.
Yep.
And reveal.
Yep. And boom. Oh, that's a surprise! Plus! Okay, so 5 and 2, so those two would get destroyed automatically, but I also lose 3 units. And then the loser of the battle also gains one of the scarabs as a compensation point. You can use those scarabs to turn them in for different resources in the night phase. And then the winner also will gain one permanent battle point as well over here. And then can also have a temporary for gaining that area. One more.
Whoa.
Five.
Dang.
Well, that's it for me. Go ahead.
You know, the thing with temporary points, Tim, is they're just that, temporary. Okay, so for my turn, I'm going to go ahead and place my token on the white tableau card here, and I'm going to purchase the Deep Sand Snake. And because I have the Priestess token, it costs one less prayer point. So I drop that down by one instead of two. And I will place this here at this district.
So really? I'm going to pay two to teleport five of mine to here.
Yep.
And then we initiate battle.
How badly do you want to get wrecked in this battle?
You know, I have a feeling I'm not going to get wrecked too bad. I think I'll be okay.
You think so?
I believe so.
One unit versus four. Four strength.
Oh, wait, is it four or five? It's five.
Interesting. I shall play this card and discard this one. And I'm also going to add on this secret divine intervention card that I want you to know that I'm adding right here.
Sounds good. For some reason, I feel like it's a bluff. Are we ready?
Ready? Three, here we go. One, two, three. Ooh, exact same card. Look at that mirror match. Okay, I for sure am going to get destroyed. So I lose my unit right away. My secret divine intervention card is a trap. It's a bluff. So that one is a complete bluff. It has absolutely no effect other than to discard that card itself. And strength-wise, Nasir right now is at 5-8, and I only had 3 plus 1, so that's 4. So my unit will get destroyed because the blood symbol will tell you how many units that you've lost. So I automatically will lose 1, and then Nasir also will lose 2 because he has no shields to defend against that fight. But as the winner, he's also going to gain 1 permanent battle point, and then he will also gain control of that territory, so he also will take that temporary point too from me.
Sounds good. Mm-hmm.
And also we'll get 1 scarab in return, my measly participation award, and that's it.
And then should we
discard these cards, and we're good. Well then, I am going to use another Divine Intervention card, and I'll play this one. So this one is going to give me plus 2 to my prayer points. Discard that, and I gain 1 and 2. Did you already buy the Hand of God?
Yes, I did.
You did. Okay, I am going to buy the Domination for white. Oh, blue, sorry, blue. Can I buy the blue Domination card, please?
Yes.
So this tile is really simple. All it does is give you a permanent victory point, prayer point, fame point. I don't know what it's called anymore, victory point. Okay, and that's it. Done.
All right, my turn. I'm gonna go ahead and pray.
Nice.
It's gonna give me 3 prayer points, nice and simple. That's it.
I am going to recruit, just bring one of my guys back over here.
I'm gonna buy the Legion, the max 7.
All right, so for my turn, I'm gonna take the movement action. Mm-hmm. And one of the, as previously stated, the bonus of the Sand Snake is plus 1 to movement. So I'm gonna take 1 movement to move outside of the district walls, and then another 2, the obelisk right here, and I'm gonna drag along my entire troop, get this 1 temporary point, and that'll end my turn.
Where are you taking your anaconda?
I'm taking it straight to everybody's doorstep next turn.
All right, sorry.
What I'm going to do is I'm going to first use one of my tokens to buy a red charge. Now, because I have the Priestess, it costs me 0. Now, with my silver coin, I'm going to move again. So I pay cost of 2, and I'm going to teleport my units.
Choose wisely where you want to teleport, sir. Damn it! I freaking knew it, man!
So we initiate combat again.
Just want to let you know, like, last time I held back.
Yeah. I don't know
now I will.
What not holding back is going to do for
use
you.
Use every single card at my disposal.
Who's going to win?
One versus 5.
Fight!
Let's see. One thing to note, too, is that the defender, if there is a situation where there's a tie, the defender is the one who wins. But I think I know what I'm going to do.
I don't think there's going to be a tie in this
battle. For some reason, I don't think so either. So I'm discarding 1, and this is the one I'm playing.
Okay, then I'm gonna play this and discard this one. You have no idea what I'm about to play.
Ready?
Three, two, one.
Oh, again.
Only
again,
one.
Mirror match.
Look at that. Twice in a row, mirror match. Okay, so I have to retreat to an adjacent region, I think. So we're gonna go to the open one right there, to a free region. Nice. And no casualties lost because we both block. Mm-hmm. But Nasir does gain a battle point. Mm-hmm. For victory. And you also gain that temporary point too from away from me.
Sounds good.
Ooh. And you get a scarab beetle.
And I get a scarab. Final turn. And I'm just going to recruit. Actually, just two. Two prayer points. Going from 2 points to four. That's it. All right, night phase again. Okay, well, I can't use the same joke from last time anyway. So the temple over there, there's no control. I don't have two units to sacrifice there, so we're gonna ignore that one. Next one, though, goes to Nasir.
I won't be sacrificing this, but I will take advantage of the 3 points on that side.
Oh, you're not gonna sacrifice one for a point?
Well, I mean, five? I think I'm gonna... For some reason, I feel like I'll be getting a bunch of points anyways.
Interesting.
So now we're gonna go here. And this one, you're gonna gain 3 prayer points.
Which I did.
Which you did. And you got the temporary ready. Next up is Adoration.
Oh, I got it. 2.
Each player gains the number of prayer points shown in temples. Okay, so Josh gains 2 for that. And then we are going to gain 2 prayer points for everybody. 1, 2. We're gonna move our action tokens out. Nice. 2. Everyone moves their action tokens off. And then draw a DI card in turn order.
So I would draw first.
Mm-hmm. Oh, am I second?
Yep. Okay. Back to me. The awakening phase.
During that, I also get to build one, which I will do here.
And I'm gonna turn in my scarab token for 1 extra prayer point.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so these scarab tokens, we can exchange for prayer points, we can exchange for units to add onto the map, or we can also exchange them for a DI card as well. There's like an error in the rulebook, apparently. So instead of just one, you can actually exchange 2 for 1 Divine Invention card, which I'm gonna do just that, and 1 extra card for me. Oh my god, the gods have rewarded me with the most powerful card in the game.
It's another
plus 10 prayer points.
All right.
And then determine player order. Whoever's in last place.
I go last. So I go first again.
Yeah, whoever's in last place gets to determine it.
So I have the least points.
So whoever has the last,
I'll go first again.
Yeah, for the last person, yeah.
Yeah.
All right, I'm done.
Strategically in last place.
Mm-hmm. I'll do second.
All right.
Cool.
Then this is the third.
Back to you, Joshua.
Again. I will build.
Ooh.
Build my last tier of the pyramid, which I get to turn this last piece over. And that gives me a gold token. So the gold token lets me, essentially, if I have purchased one of the colored tiles here already, if I use the gold token, I get to repurchase either another card or one that's already been bought. Mm-hmm. And I could use it the same term that I acquired it. So
nice.
I will actually go ahead and use it. I will purchase the recruiting scribe.
Back to me. I shall recruit. And I also get plus 3 free recruits, so I'm gonna take my 3 frees and put it in my district right now. And I'm also going to recruit, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I'm gonna spend all 6 points to recruit 6 more. And honestly, it might be the dumbest move I've ever done this entire game so far, but it's fine. Okay. Nasir, you're up.
Okay, so on my turn, I'm going to buy. So I'm going to place this here. I'm going to pay my cost of 4 minus 1, so just 3, to get the mummy.
Okay, my turn?
Yep.
All right, I'm going to place this token here, which allows me to buy a blue card, and I'm going to purchase the spy card.
Great.
Now, the spy card lets me, essentially, if I'm engaged in battle, I get to look at the opponent's a battle card before I choose my battle card and my DI card, which is really, really powerful if you're planning certain builds. Hint, hint.
That card honestly is a dirty card.
It's really good.
It's so bad. That card is rigged.
Yeah.
All right, that's it for my turn.
Back to me. And I'm going to just play this. So 2 Ankh, done.
Okay.
That's it.
On my turn, I'm going to build. What I'm going to do is max out my blue pyramid. So by paying 7,
I'm gonna go ahead and take the... What do I want to do?
You seem conflicted, sir.
I do. I'm gonna take the recruit action, and I'm gonna recruit my sandworm to here. And that allows me to recruit up to two more troops that are tied to the sandworm. But because I have the recruiting scribe, I get to also recruit up to three more. So I'm just gonna go ahead and add two more to this. And that's gonna end my turn.
I love how both of you have the exact same mirror matches from last time. Last time, Josh had the sandworm too, destroyed me. However, you have a snake this time. Snake. Last time, Nasir had a snake.
Yeah.
But he did have the mummy last time too. Mm-hmm. And me, I don't honestly don't have any idea what I'm doing. I'm gonna gain two Ankh for this one again, so I'm at four. That's it.
Okay. I am also just gonna gain three Ankh. So I'm also at four.
Weird flex, but okay.
And I'm gonna also do the same, but I get three, so I'm at eight.
Nice. So I see you two are both following the most powerfulest character in the game right now. Follow myself, suit.
My instincts.
I see. I'm gonna raise pyramid for four, my final tier, and switch this one on to the final one, which means I can now get one of these temporary victory points.
Temporary.
Nice.
I'm going to buy the reinforcement by paying a cost of three. Mm-hmm. What reinforcement does is when I recruit, I get to recruit as many units as I want for free. What I'm going to do next too is by using my silver token, I'm going to recruit and then just bring all of these up here.
I'm going to go and purchase the red movement tile, which just gives me plus one to movement every single time I move.
So, Josh, in Kemet, you want to gain victory points. Why did I come out of nowhere? Okay. Last one's going to be movement. And can you move that one soldier over there to that one?
Oh,
that's it.
Simple. You're trying to lose, right?
Yep.
What I'm going to do, also move.
Oh my god, I swear. How many movement points do you get?
Two.
Two? With the mummy?
Yeah.
Oh my god.
No, just one additional on top of the
one. Oh, okay.
So I am going to move four pieces.
Dude.
Wow.
And let me hear.
Okay. Combat begins again.
Combat begins.
This guy really wants to
I'm sorry, Tim.
Mess with my most powerful deck of cards right now.
Okay. You're on your last couple cards, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Now, the mummy, I don't know if I mentioned earlier, but it gives me default additional plus two combat. So I have four units here, plus two, so six. Also, because I bought the charge card over here, and I'm the one attacking, that gives me an additional combat. So I have seven before I use any of my combat cards.
The hell? What else does he give you? Paralyze your units with his straps and stuff? Okay. I shall discard this one. And play this one. And I'm also going to play this.
Ooh. Just so you know, those are three bluff cards, so...
I just want to let you know, these are the cards I'm playing.
You're playing three?
Correct.
Changes of things. But not by much. You know what? I'll stick to this.
Okay.
I'm going to discard this, and I'll play this.
That's your reveal?
Wait.
Which one's your reveal?
Yeah, this is my reveal.
Okay, ready? Yeah. On three. One, two, three. Ooh, this might hurt, sir. Okay.
Ooh, no.
Four, five, six for me, and you have right now seven, eight, nine.
So this is six.
Six, seven, eight.
Seven, eight, nine. Yeah.
Nine?
Wait, four, five, six, seven.
Oh, okay.
Right?
Yep. Eight, nine. Eight, nine. Dang, okay. So my secret cards here. I have plus one to strength, plus one to strength, and then blood. Ooh. Oh my god, I have more strength by one.
Oh, dude. No.
So ties in defense battles would actually go to the defender, but I lost by one strength here. So let's see, I lose no units though. Zero blood drawn. But you will, actually you block both too. So mine just withdraw to an adjacent region again. And permanent points for you.
Thank you.
And participation for me, and I think that's it.
Do I get this too or no?
Oh yeah, you would gain the temporary point for controlling.
I don't know if you guys have a lot more time left.
Dang, I was counting on this one, man. I was so close.
Okay.
All right. Night phase again. I wish I could remember these, but the fact that there's nine steps.
Yeah, there's so many.
Okay. First one is control of that temple for you. You want to sacrifice too?
Yes, I will.
8 points. Dude, we have to game on green, man. Oh, I have no choice now.
All right, no, it's okay.
He's at eight.
I got this.
Do I get a...
Okay. Oh, yeah, sorry.
Am I at eight, though, or did you guys miscount?
No, he's at eight right now, yeah.
Right now?
Eight right now, yeah.
Let's continue.
For now. Oh, you're right. Okay, so eight there, and then the next one is going to be the Delta Temple. Do you want to sacrifice?
No.
Okay, and the next temple? This one?
But I will get the points for that.
Three pair of points, and then Josh's?
Two.
And no one has control of two temples?
No.
Oh, that's what he was counting for. Okay. Two temples, which means he gains another one. Dude, this ended so fast. Okay. Okay.
It's okay. I got this.
Right. Next up, prayer points. Everyone gains two prayer points. One, two, and then all the action markers are moved off of their board.
I get my seven.
DI card draws in turn order. Oop. Yep, and this here.
Oops.
Veteran tokens. Okay, I'm gonna discard one prayer, one veteran token in order to gain one prayer point. And then lastly, the awakening phase for this year.
So I get to build my pyramid up one.
And in case you're wondering still, there are different cards that activate during the awakening phase. Nothing actually happens during that time. Mm-hmm. But Nasir has that card where he can build a one tier of the pyramid for free. And then the last part of this night phase is to determine turn order, mm-hmm. starting with blue.
I'm going to go first again.
Okay. Good choice.
I got plans. I got plans.
I have plans. Maybe I'll go last. No, I'll go second.
Okay. Go second.
Yep. If it goes back to Nasir and he has 9 points still, he will win again. So me and Josh have one turn left.
It won't happen. It's not happening.
So turn us around.
Okay. First turn?
Yep.
Dude, 9 points are right.
Yeah, that was kind of quick.
Okay, so for my turn, I'm going to place my token here. Okay. And I'm going to purchase the Act of God tile for 3 points because I have the minus one.
This one?
Two, three. Yes, the beetle with the silver token.
Oh, yeah.
Which gives me an extra extra action token each round, which I could use right now.
Cool.
But I'm actually going to use my gold token and use it for...
Can you kill him instead of buying stuff right now?
I'm buying stuff. I need to buy stuff. I'm going to use it for the Divine Will, which allows me to use my golden token as a movement or recruit action instead of just buying.
Oh, there we go. Okay, nice.
And now with my silver token, I'm going to do a movement action. And I'm actually going to move my Sand Snake. It gets a plus one to movement already and a one movement also. And I also have the charge, I think it's called, which gives me another addition of movement. So I get to move three spaces total. One, two, three.
Nice.
And I'm going to move my entire, most of it, leave one here. And that
for repercussion's sake, right?
Battle. Yeah. Battle here. I think these are your cards that you've discarded.
Yes.
But I have my spy effect.
Oh, so you're
I get
right.
to look at his battle card before I choose my cards.
Spy's really good.
You've battled before, but...
Wait, Nasir, are you sweating over there? Because I see some hesitation here.
I see. You know what I'm going to do?
So I'm at five and you're at three. Base.
Okay. Oh, he nullifies too. Yeah. Okay.
I'm going to activate that one.
So you're at eight?
Yes.
And I was at five. Okay, so I'm going to play this one and I'm going to discard. You have to choose to discard one too.
Yeah.
Okay. So discard one. So I'll place that one here and then flip. Plus four, one with an additional damage and power.
Okay.
So that brings me to nine. What was your DI
Do you
card?
Think that was enough?
Yes.
It was.
Okay, so I win the exchange, which means Nasir loses, but let's add up the damage. So you take two casualties and I also take two casualties. So these two go here. And that's it.
And then this unit, I'll go back.
Back there. And
you know what? I'll take this one and I gain one. Well, I guess.
So I gain a permanent victory point for winning.
Yep. Nice.
One here.
Scarab.
And a scarab for Nasir. Nasir loses his one temporary point because I gained this control. I control this obelisk now. But my turn isn't done yet because it is still daytime. Mm-hmm. These are the discard pile. Discard. I'm gonna place this one. This card here lets me remove one unit from an opposing faction.
Nice.
During the day, and I'm gonna choose to remove this unit here, which drops it down again to one more. So he is now at 7 victory points, which gives us a little breathing room.
There we go. There we go. Good turn. You good?
I told you I had a plan. It was a slow build up.
Nice. Now my turn to kill you off. Okay, I'm gonna play the exact same card as Josh, which is gonna allow me to remove a unit. And I'm gonna take away that one over there, like one of the green ones.
Mm-hmm.
Nice. And then...
Oh, whoops. Well, all my units are dead.
I'm going to move and teleport, spending 2 points, 1 and 2. And let us begin combat yet again, sir.
I see.
Give me my region back.
Wait, did you get all your cards back?
I did get all my
cards back. Oh, this changes things, Tim.
Yep. When so everyone has the exact same hand of 8 cards. When they're all used up, you get them all back again.
Wait,
so,
this is yours?
No, that's what Nasir was talking about.
It's yours.
Tell me why I was shuffling my cards just now.
Right.
You played yours already?
Yeah, I played one.
This is my. You have 3 strength, right?
Huh?
You have 3 strength?
3 strength, yes.
And versus 5? Okay, okay. No problem. Watch me lose this fight. I'm not gonna rage quit. I'm gonna flip the table if I lose this fight. I don't know why I feel like I'm gonna lose this fight. Okay, I'll do that. And I'm gonna discard this one. Okay, we're good. Ready?
Yeah.
And 3, 2, 1. Oh, 4. Okay, that's scary. 4 plus 3 is 7. And I'm at 5. I did lose this fight!
Oh. No!
My math is so bad! No.
Wait!
No, I did lose this fight! Because we're at the same exact amount. So I'm at 2 strength, you're at 2.
And since I'm defending.
I forgot about 4. I like you used your 5.
Give me the
momentum? No! I had enough time. I was like, oh, he already uses 5. He's going to do 3. Okay, that was dumb. So I would have to withdraw. So defender wins. If the defender's winner, they gain 1 veteran token. Which is, so let's go ahead and give you this first.
So on my turn, what I'm going to do first is I'm going to buy a unit. I'm going to buy the Sphinx over here. And place it right there. This also gives me an additional victory point.
Nice.
And then here's a Sphinx, which gives 2 combat 2 combat points and 1 additional movement.
Mm-hmm.
Then I'm gonna place my silver and I'm gonna move. Whoops, I forgot to pay the cost. So 11 minus 3, we are at 8. And then I'm gonna move. So I'm gonna take these 4
mm-hmm.
and and then we commence battle.
Okay. Tell me you have a Recruit the Sandworm card or something.
All right. I still have my spy, so let's see how that goes. Oh, he has a fresh hand.
Oh, God. Zero hesitation. Let me play my most powerful card. The +5 weapon card with the black blood, which is undefendable damage, is the strongest card of all the combat cards.
Okay, I'm discarding that, and I'll play that.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So we resolve.
I have what, 3? I obviously lose.
Oh, shoot.
And so I get a permanent victory point.
And lose 2.
Permanent victory point over here.
Then I steal Josh's.
Nice. Oh, frick, dude.
Yeah.
And then Josh gets the scarab.
Get 1 scarab. All right, Tim, you know what to do
this
next.
This is our last turn, yeah.
You know what to do. I'm going to move. I'm going to move my sandworm over. And we're gonna engage in battle. So go ahead and I still have my spy active.
Your sandworm, so you are at?
I'm at 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I'm attacking +7, I'm at 7 base.
Ooh.
Let's make it, I'm gonna play him, discard this, and I'm gonna play that.
Okay, so what are the numbers right now?
Okay, yours so is. I'm at 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, +5, that's 12.
Nice.
And then you are 1, 2, 3, 4 plus plus that's 5. So 12, 5, I win, but I get 2 casualties. Oh, I get 3 casualties, but since I block 1, I only get 2 casualties, and you lose both of yours. which means your Sphinx has to leave.
Look at all my units.
He has only one unit left on the board. You tell me he's about to win with zero units on the board.
Psych. I got this. So because I'm out of combat cards, I get to draw them all back into my hand. Mm-hmm. Those go to the discard pile.
Nice.
And you get a scarab. Oh, so I get a permanent.
Yeah, you get a permanent. Here you go. So not scarab. Yeah, scarab back.
And then you got my temporary?
Yep.
Okay. Nice.
Temporary, and then that's it.
Cool. Then for my turn, I shall move into that final region, please.
All right, so five, right?
Yes, yeah, psych. Packs, five. All seven.
Wait, you have the seven?
Oh, I have the seven.
Oh, snap. Oh, let's go. I have
all seven. It's not over yet. Fine. Someone will die today. But this time, I will ensure it.
Tim, my spy card just for the round.
Let's see.
Watch me lose this money.
Go, just max it all.
I'm just gonna max it.
He just got his hand back, so he does still have five potentially.
Got his hand back?
Okay. I forgot.
Okay, no problem.
I'm playing this one.
My math calculations are perfectly correct this time. I'm gonna discard this one. Reveal. On three. One, two, three. Nice. Okay, complete overkill. But so my strength is, I'm at 7 plus 4, 11 versus you're at 3 plus 4 is 7. So 11 versus 7, highest strength, and you also lose one casualty. But creatures also have to be tied to that. So his creature's gone too. I will take that one along with a permanent, please. And the temporary. Drop that down to 8. Yes. It's not over. It's not over. That's what I'm talking about.
Very desperate, eh?
Nice. Back to you.
Back to me. Now, I'm going to recruit once again because I have this card. I get to recruit as many units as I want for free. So, I guess
Oh, is that the level 4 sapphire?
Yep.
Dang.
Is that as many or just one troop?
As many.
Wow, that's right? Really good.
Yeah.
Oops. That's a clutch card. Considering your entire army was destroyed.
Yeah.
We can't let him travel anywhere.
I know, it's such a good card. I'm also wondering too, and feel free to let me know in the comments if you know the answer to this, but I was wondering if when you recruit, can you only recruit the maximum in a district, which would be 5?
So my turn?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, I'm out of movements. How do I do this? It doesn't matter. I'm going to build the red tower all the way up. I'll do two here. So that'll be 5.
Mm-hmm. Okay, back to me.
Mm-hmm.
Move. And I'm going to spend 2 points. Oh, I don't have 2 points. Wait.
Yes. So you're saying I still have a move and you guys are undefendable?
Hold on. I think I'm going to just gain 2 prayer points, just like that.
Ooh,
that's it. Confident in what's going on.
I'm going to activate this card. It allows me to move to a monument without any cost. I'm going to take my group back to the motherland.
To the same farm.
And combat begins.
Okay, I saw my spy active.
Mm-hmm.
He only has one temporary. Where is that temporary from? Oh, from your pyramid, huh?
I have 5, 6, 7. I'm attacking 8 base. 9, 10, 11.
I'm at 4.
This is a game.
It sounds like you've done the math, sir.
All right, I'm going to play this.
Ooh, that sounds like it's game to me.
I'm going to discard this. Okay. That's all I have.
So what's the numbers now for blue versus green?
So I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
5 versus?
Versus
11?
11?
11.
What the hell?
So okay. I got absolutely
obliterated.
So let's go back. Because I lost 2 casualties and my sandworm is no longer tied to a troop. It also goes back. It doesn't go back to district because the sandworm is unique and it can't be in city walls.
Here's your victory point.
Thank you. What?
It's hard for me to let go.
And I get a veteran point.
Yep.
Not that it matters.
It matters right now. And my turn.
Yeah, I believe
one final.
So.
All right, Tim, you got to make 3 victory points right here.
I must go to a city, destroy everything in one turn.
Oh, and he gets a temporary for controlling. Temple.
So you can make
One move.
You can make 5 in one move.
There's
I think
one
too,
move.
Right?
I'm gonna spend 2 points to teleport.
Ooh.
My troops, 5 all the way over here, and And the final battle has commenced. Five versus mummy and five.
Discard.
Also, I don't know if you read, but the green faction, it says that you can't play any combat cards on your last turn.
I see. And you lose. So you're implying it's my last turn and I'm going to win regardless. I'm okay with that.
Yeah.
I'm playing this one. And just for fun, I'm going to place this card down here.
What are we doing for fun? No, no. Okay.
So ready?
Yeah.
Obliterate!
4, 5. I think we tie. And I think it goes to defend, right? So 5 and 5. I'm at 10. And you're at 5 plus 4, 9. Plus no, wait. Mummy, 11.
Do you have an attacker bonus?
No, I don't.
Wait, you're at 5 plus 5, 10, right?
Yeah, I'm at 10 versus 11. You have 11.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
Dang, that's game. Okay. But you lose 2 units, though.
I do lose 2 units. That's important.
Come on.
And that's dang. It. That's game. Yeah, that's game. Yeah. He's above 9.
That's game. Good game, man.
Good game. I tried that slow build. It was too slow.
Honestly, creeped out of nowhere because like I think I was like kind of confident. Went to 4 and I'm realizing that, wait, my resources are going to run out real fast towards like halfway point, and freaking this comes out of nowhere with this giant
This card right here just lets you do so much without having to worry about money, which is pretty nice.
Yeah.
And then these two just make it easier to just build and build. Mm-hmm. It's pretty dope.
You like this game?
This is a really fun game.
Nice.
I don't think it's too hard to pick up. I feel like it might seem more intimidating.
Yeah.
Or like more complicated than you would expect, but it's pretty fun. Like you had, when you were explaining it to us, you're literally either just placing a token here or you know, it's pretty simple in terms of what actions you're taking.
Mm-hmm.
So I feel like it's really easy to pick up, and it's been pretty fun.
Yeah, because it's quick, right? You take an action, or you take one action on your turn. That's it, out of like the 5 available. But the nuances actually come in all the tiles that you're buying and reading through each individual power. I think that's the one thing I don't like, is that when you're buying the tiles, like maybe you should be restricted to a certain number, like 10.
A limit.
You know, instead of like however many tiles you want. I feel like you should be restricted maybe to like 10 or something.
The other fun thing that I think could be interesting is if instead of choosing one and then hiding one, you pick 2 and then one randomly gets selected.
That's kind of fun too, because then it's like still an element of surprise, right?
Yeah. Plus also, because it's easy to be like, oh, I'm going to pick my highest combat and weakest, you know, and discard my weakest.
Yeah.
But if you do that, it's like high risk, high reward. You could totally steamroll or you could lose.
That's true.
And it kind of makes you more cognizant of the combats you might have down the line.
Mm-hmm.
So you can either stack 2 really good, you know, combat cards in your first battle and then leave yourself open later.
Mm-hmm.
Or you could roll the dice and like, okay, I'm going to put 1 good one, 1 bad and see how it goes. Yeah. It adds more of an element of like randomness, which, you know, may be a good thing, maybe a bad thing, kind of depends.
I feel like this is the first game too that I've showed you that we haven't played with dice.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah. Which is why, it's interesting.
Yeah. Is there anything you don't like about this game?
I would enjoy just a little bit more randomness into the game. I guess like you said, the combat with like dice rolls just kind of gives a little bit more luck. But I think it's very streamlined with very simple actions that you could take, but also deceivingly simple, where again, like you said, the variations in the tiles. And this is only what I think not even half of the available tiles that you could actually play with. So I'm pretty sure if we explore, we could come up with some crazy builds.
I know.
And some crazy strategies.
It is also nice too, like for the map, I like how they restrict half the map, because then you have more play interaction, right? Because we have the entire map. Can you imagine? Like, we'll be avoiding fights like majority of the time. You
know? Yeah. Mm-hmm. So
that's like, it's nice how they restrict it to like the player count, which is really cool. Cool. Yeah. Thanks for joining me, guys.
Yeah.
Good win this year.
Glad to be back.
Let us know down in the comments below. We should bring them back and which game you want to see them play next. So thank you all so much for watching today's gameplay. And we will see you all in the next one.
See ya.
See ya.